The Bengal Business Conclave, spread over 2 days, is the first ever landmark event in this city. On behalf of the Government of West Bengal, I would now request Chief Secretary Shri Rajiv Sinha to welcome the delegates.
Good afternoon to everyone.
Respected my Honorable Finance Minister, Amit Mitraji, my Chief Secretary, Rajiv Sinha, Home Secretary, Alapan Bandopadhyay, my colleague, Vandana, my colleague, Shubhendu Odhikari, Firad Hakim, Shishir Odhikari, and all the public representatives, my all the foreign friends, foreign dignitaries, foreign diplomats, my Council General from Australia, Russia, UK, China, Japan, Germany, Bangladesh, Nepal, Bhutan, and also my distinguished delegates from 20 countries from the world, my Bangladesh Minister, Mr. Nurul Majid Muhammad Humayunji, and also from Bhutan, my Minister, Loknath Sharmaji. And also I have so many industrialist friends from different parts of the world and different parts of the country and different parts from my state also. If I can remember a few names, then of course Horst Neutia, Mr. Modi, Mr. Rudra Chatterjee, this is Umesh Chowdhury, Mayank, this is Dhanukaji, Budhiyaji, and Mahul, and so many, and also the officers, press media, and all. Thank you so much for coming over here. Especially once Amitda told me that this year we are not going to organize this Bengal Business Summit, Bishwa Bangla, what we call. Next year we'll do it. After 1 year, it will be better so that people can get the time also for their working capacity and all this, for their efficiency, for the projects and all this. So I said, okay. Then suddenly we have decided, let us do one thing in Digha Convention Center. Because Kolkata, there is a big convention center. I am proud to say it is one of the biggest World Convention Center in Kolkata. That is a destination for the industry also, for everything nowadays. But Digha, it is just far away from Kolkata, not too far, 3 kilometers by road. Road connectivity is there, port connectivity is there, train connectivity is there, even the human connectivity is there, even tourism connectivity is there, industry connectivity is there, port connectivity is there, so many things are there. So I said, let us do it in the Digha, and there we have to set up first one small convention center. Let us try for that. If we can set up one convention center, so what we can start today, it will work for tomorrow. because this convention center, there is a hotel accommodation also attached to that. It is about 70 rooms are available here. So the corporate house and the industrial house, always they want to organize a seminar, some convention or their office meetings. So there the employees and the officers, they want that 2 days they will work and two days they must enjoy the enjoy for relaxation also. And Digha is a beautiful seaside. And now you will appreciate that within these few years, we are in the government about 8 years, but within a few years, Digha has been developed like anything. And again here, I'm proud to say that my 7 kilometers, just like Marina Drive, the beach is coming up. Road is already completed. Only 2 bridges are coming up. I think within April or March, it will be completed. And this is a place. It is just adjacent of Puri. Puri temple, the famous temple. We are also doing one big temple here. The Mashibari, what we say. And so there is a scope. And Digha, within this short span, I know that in presence of my 20 countries, UK, Poland, Estonia, Netherlands, Argentina, Republic of Korea, Singapore, UAE, USA, Australia, France, Russia, Italy, Thailand, Germany, Japan, China, Bangladesh, and Bhutan. Even I am very pleased to see that United Nations, like that of UNIDO and UNCTAD, also they are also present here. And the team from World Bank also, they are also is here. Even Asian Development Bank, they also gave us just 150 million for an innovative project last week also. We are happy. We want to congratulate them. There are global CEO from Changi Airport also. They are also present here. My German organization, KfW Solar Energy Plant of West Bengal, Digha, they are also planning something. So they are also here. Now, UK Department of Trade will be working with WBIDC. Deputy High Commissioner is also here. Thank you so much. Amazon functionaries are also here. So eminent business leaders from West Bengal and other parts of the country are also here. The MSME sector is also here. Now you'll be happy to know, industry depends on economic situation also. The economic situation is something very important nowadays. Now, what I can say for business, if I give you some example, what is the situation of my country? I'm not going to criticize that. The reality bites sometimes. The All India level and my state level. Our state also, after 34 years of leftist rules, it was a bad and worst situation. From there, we have overcome the situation. And now, if you see the GDP growth, red down, the doom and gloom, our country economic situation, what is a fact? 16-17 second quarter, GDP growth rate was 8.87%, but 19-20 second quarter is 4.55, very bad. Industry growth also red down. 15-16, it was 9.58%. 18-19, it is 6.86%. Like manufacturing growth rate down also. 15-16, 13.06. 18-19, 6.94. Now, index of industrial production growth rate down. In September 2018, 4.63%. In September 2019, it is minus 4.27%. FDI inflow growth rate down. 14-15, it was 22%. 15-16, it was 35%. 18-19, it is 1%. So from even unemployment rate is also highest last 45 years. But you'll be happy to know, I am proud to say that Bengal, we have decreased the unemployment about 40% in our country. It depends on attitude, working capacity and everything. I want to tell you why you will come to Bengal. If you compare, then come to the point. industrial production IIP of India was only 3.6%, 18-19. But West Bengal, it is 7.2%, exactly double that of India. Unemployment, I said, 40% is already declined. Even India is facing highest rate of unemployment these 45 years. Even you'll be happy to know that the poverty rate, it is very interesting, and highest decline recorded by any state of the country, it is 6% in Bengal, the poverty alleviation program through the social schemes, social security schemes, and so many poverty alleviation schemes, it is 6% decline. That means we worked. We, West Bengal government, together, along with public representatives, along with press media, along with civil society, along with my officers, along with my employees, we work together, and that's why this is a good result for our government. State plan expenditure, if you see, six times higher. Social sector expenditure has grown by 4.5 times. Physical infrastructure expenditure has grown by 5 times. Even I think Amitda must provide one handbook to you so you can get the details about that. Now business, it matters. Ease of doing business. If you see the world parameters, 187 parameters, then you will see we are number one in this country. We are number one in this country for ease of doing business. Now lending by banks to the MSME, we are number one. Now skill development, we are number one. Now e-tendering, we are number one. Now rural connectivity and the rural housing, we are number one. In generation of 100 days work for the poor people, it is we are number one. And number one in expenditure outlay for 100 days program also. Now, there are so many areas where we develop so much because of our intention and our integrity. The business, what we need today, business, we want that you must invest for business. But where you will choose the place where you have the scope and hope for the future? Where you have the opportunity to employ the people and business with smiling face? Nowadays, there are so many tension. Why you will take more and more tension? No. Business with relaxation. You have to be always cheerful. You have to be always, you will smile along with business. If you count only A to Z, don't count so much alphabetically word. Count A, accountability. Count B, business. Count C, credibility. Count D, dedication or devotion or determination. Count A, E, efficiency. Count G, the good governance. It means efficiency, good governance, smiling face, integrity, credibility, helping hands, and you must feel happy wherever you are doing the business. Nowadays, everything is available, but happiness is must be very much available to all of you. And that's why we feel that Bengal, it is not only we are proud of Bengal because I am staying here. That is not the cause. If you see the main cause, then you will see my Bangladesh friends are here. My Bhutan friends are here. My Southeast Asian countries are here. Ask them that Bengal is not only the gateway. It is the lifeline of the nation for business. And it is the lifeline for the Asian countries also. Bengal have the potentiality, where if you have the potentiality, there you can do the business. Where there is no potentiality, you cannot do for business. Now, I have so many industrial friends. They can tell you, after our new government came in within these 8 years, anybody can say politically whatever they can say, it is their prerogative. But nobody can deny the facts that Bengal is now the charming figures for the industrial development and for every development. If you see Digha, this destination, sea beach destination, before 8 years ago, and if you see today, it is an international destination for the industrial business, for the industry, for the tourism industry also. It's an international, it became an international city. And there are so many areas. Bengal have the deep forest, deep sea. We have so many, even hill areas. Bengal is always, and the main beauty of Bengal is unity in diversity is our origin. We don't divide the people. We never uttered a single word against of any caste, any creed, any religions. We believe all are we together. World have become a sweet family. Somebody may stay in UK. Somebody may stay in USA. Somebody may stay in Bhutan, Bangladesh, Italy, Korea, Japan, Germany, Netherlands. But we feel we are the same family. Now if you see the India, unity, diversity is our origin. Ours is a vast country. So many languages, so many religions, so many castes, so many creed, so many community. But not a single person can utter a word that Bengal, they are deprived or they are facing any difficulties for that. Even Bengal gives a vision for all of the countries. And that's why Bengal is always cosmopolitan. Calcutta is always cosmopolitan. Our every parts of this country, our every parts of this city, this state, it is cosmopolitan. When nobody will stood up for a particular social cause, the Bengal will do that. Because it is the Bengal, it is not only today. Bengal have produced so many Nobel laureates, like Rabindranath Tagore, like even recently Abhijit and all, Mother Teresa, and there are so many. So Bengal is a place, it has produced so many great sons of this soil. And Bengal will never give you the discrimination or the separate attitude to divide a new policy. No, it is not. And that's why please see that it is your own home. It is your sweet home. Now if you see Digha, what was Digha earlier, 7-8 years ago, nothing was there. Now you see, so many hotels came up. So many tourism spots came up. Tajpur, Udaipur, New Digha, Old Digha. Now the Tajpur port is also coming up. And so, 175 hotels already been set up in Digha itself, this destination. In our tourism industry, more than 13 lakhs people are already employed. My young generation are getting employment through IT industry, through software industry, through Microsoft, through so many MSME to small scale to other industry. And Bengal is always, it was top of the engineering industry, MSME industry, and so many industries. Even hotel industry investment was about 39,800 crores. And now also so many hotels are coming up. Every year 16 lakh foreign tourists are coming up in Bengal. And 8 crore domestic tourists are also there coming up. Our airport grown by 178%. And international passengers have grown about 135%. So you can imagine even Bagdogra, it is in Bengal, you will see that Bagdogra, the highest in India, the growth rate, if you see the passengers' growth rate. So from this point of view, I feel that Bangladesh is just half an hour from Bengal. Nepal, half an hour. Bhutan, just half an hour, 15-20 minutes. Now, Northeastern Eight Sister State, they are also either 15 minutes or 20 minutes or 25 minutes by flight. Even if you see Bangkok, maybe maximum 2.5 hours. Kuala Lumpur, 3 hours. Singapore, 2.5 hours. I mean, it is not too far, the other countries also. So I think that Bengal is a place, from Bengal you can nurture the other place also. And our agricultural production is also very good. And our industry, our workforce is very good. Our skilled labor, I'm telling you, within these 8 years, we have set up about 300 polytechnic colleges and the ITI colleges. We give the skill training program also. Our land bank is already there. If you want to invest, what do you need? Cooperation, yes, we do agree. Friendship, yes, we do agree. Land bank, yes, we have. Land use policy, we have. The land utilization policy, yes, we have. Synergy, one umbrella project, yes, we have. New tourism policy, yes, we have. IT policy, yes, we have. T-tourism policy, T-tourism industry, yes, we have. IT policy, yes, we have. Now, I have the land bank, I have the power bank, I have the man force, I have the workforce, I have the skilled labor, I have the talented students, young generation, our boys and girls. Actually, I am proud to say that they are working from UK to USA to NASA to Japan to China, everywhere. If you see, it is a Bengal workforce. They are working throughout the world. So I will request, I will appeal to all of you that please invest in Bengal. We will give you full cooperation, full assistance, whatever we can within our limitation. Already the land bank setup is there. So many industries, even the IT sector, more than 200 acres has been provided for the Silicon Valley program also. So many icon sectors, IT sector is also coming up. Our transport sector, it's a potential sector. Very, very good and potential sector, our transport sector. We have the demand also. When you have the demand, you have to meet up the demand. So how do you do this? Do that? It is because if you have the, I have the ready-made business. You have to use it. I have the ready-made business in every nook and corner. You just use it. I will not tell you for gloom and doom situation. I will not tell you the loot and scoop situation. I will tell you always a smiley situation. Invest your money for the betterment of the future, and I can tell you one day the Bengal will be number one destination of the world. Please remember that. And I remember correctly one country, I should not mention the name because I don't want to embarrass anybody. But they said, within 20 years, Bengal is the number one. So we have started survey from now, which sector we want to invest the money. We have set up already 26 helicopter site. Here also, we have the helicopter site, permanent helipad sector. We are doing some regional air connectivity also. But my friends are there from all over the world. I will request you, please give us some international flight from Kolkata. Earlier, there was a British Airways. But now, I have seen that before 10 years ago, it was withdrawn. But now we are giving the fuel subsidy also. So you can give us some European flight also, that I will request all of you, if you have any opportunity, you can pursue this matter. Even Changi Airport also, they have Singapore Airlines. They have already started a green airport there in Ondal. So my Balughat is also coming up, air connectivity. Malda is also coming up. My Kuchbihar is also coming up. Durgapur is already there on Dal. Calcutta is already there. Bagdogra is already there. Like this, there are so many areas where you can invest your money and you can enjoy your hospitality, your friendship. And Bengal, they love the hospitality. They love all of you. At least one thing you can get from us, good culture, because Bengal is the cultural capital of India. You can get a good behavior, good transparency, good accountability, and our credentials is our credibility. If you can remember that, that will help you. With these words, I welcome all my 20 country friends, my diplomats, my consul general, my favorite delegates, and all the captain of the industries from all over the country, captain of the industries from the world, captain of the industry from IT sector, or from MSME sector, or from different sector. And not only I am present here, my all government, along with Chief Secretary, Home Secretary, Police, and all administration, BM, Partho Ghosh, Salman, and all we are present here. It's a collective family. You give us life, means working life, We want that you enjoy your life, you give us your business life, and we will give you our all best wishes or the smiley offerings always so that you can conquer the world. Don't think it is not your state or it is not your country. Yes, it is your country. Your country I love. It is just like my country, and my country is also your country. Please consider that. And I am sure that within these 2 days program, you will be able to deliver the goods, and our government officials will give you full support. And thank you so much for taking trouble to come over here, but enjoy your sea beach also, and see the beauty of this, somebody may say it is a rural areas, but there is a rural areas also, there are some beauty. So see that area, we want to decentralize. We want to develop the areas where it is not been nurtured earlier. So for this reason, we are doing it in Digha this time. Next, our BGBS conference will be 15th and 16th December 2020. My open invitation to all of you. And before that, please do come in Digha. Enjoy your life, enjoy your style, enjoy your business, and also bring the people to invest in Bengal. Stay few days in Digha, stay few days in Sundarban, Bay of Bengal, stay few days in Darjeeling. Thank you so much. Thanks a lot. I convey my best regards to all my people of this world from behalf of our government. Our brothers and sisters, please take care for them. Take care for them. Thank you so much. Thanks a lot.
Office at Tajpur is now open. You'll be happy to sight office, and we are expecting the stakeholders to visit the field office, and you saw the drawing already, in order to start getting engaged. And we do have an intense discussion with stakeholders to take the Tajpur port forward, as the Honorable Chief Minister so desired. So that's your first interesting bite. So those who are interested in ports could visit the field office. You can talk to the managing director, WBIDC, Mrs. Vandana Yadav. We now go to the second one. Metro Coach Factory at Titagarh Wagons Limited. I think it's a unique project that they have got. I will request Mr. Umesh Chaudhary to tell us what you've got for Bengal, and what's the investment, and what's the employment in addition to what you do. It's already on. United Nations Conference on Trade and Development, UNCTAD, is here. And Improtech, this is your project, sir. So between WBIDC, FICCI, and UNCTAD, here with the exchange with Honorable Chief Minister witnessing, a UN body. You head the UNCTAD, and you're representing UNIDO, you head. And you're representing UNCTAD. Very prestigious indeed. Thank you very much. Thank you indeed. I think, Mr. Boudia, in your park, something is happening. Take a minute and talk about it, since there's so much of things on the table.
Thank you, sir. Honorable Chief Minister, ministers, dignitaries, and policy makers and policy executors, and my friends. Madam, as you are kindly aware, we are operating 5 units, because you said Bengal means business, and we are people from business world, and I can tell all my international delegates that in Bengal, we never lose 1 hour in strike and lockout. And currently we have put up two more units in our industrial park, one for engineering, one for plastic, that will add another. Already we have put up 900 people there, sir, and in the industrial park there will be an investment of 1100 crores, which will have an employment of 3000 people. And madam, you will be happy that he ready.
CDCL, may I invite KFW and WBACDCL, the your additional chief secretary now? So additional chief secretary Power is here. And would you want to exchange something? Yes, no, MOU exchange, KFC. Solar power, that's what you're doing, sir, right? Huh? 150 megawatts of solar power, that would be about 700 crores investment. 750 crores of investment being done by KfW from Germany, one of the world's leading banks and a part of the German government. And additional chief secretary and you have exchanged. Now we have to push the solar power forward indeed. Thank you very much for coming from all the way Germany. And finally, the last one. LOI being exchanged, letter of intent. As you know, UK government is still under formation and whatever process is going on. So therefore, they have to exchange LOI between WBIDC and the UK, UK Directorate of Trade, a government institution. Deputy High Commissioner himself has come. This will be a tremendous partnership for promoting trade and export between the Managing Director of WBIDC and the Deputy High Commissioner of the United Kingdom. Thank you very much indeed. Thank you. So I think we've come to the end of this inaugural session. Am I right, ma'am? So we've completed this, and therefore, now is it you have some tea for people? Yes.